to allow his will to come down. Why? Because the column that had been cut was now recorrected. Praise God.
Amen.
The connection that we had with heaven was now connected again through the blood of Jesus. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
That which we lost in the Garden of Eden is now being restored through Christ. Hallowed be your name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is where? In heaven. Continue, please.
Give us today our daily bread.
You hear that, my brethren?
Yes.
God requires us never to lack our daily bread. And everything that has to do with our social well-being. Jesus gave us a format of prayer. He said to them, from now onwards, this is how you ought to pray. We call it the Lord's Prayer. And sometimes we pray it, we recite it like a poem. When you recite it like a poem, it will have no power in your life. It will be just a good statement you're making, and it will have no effect in your life. It was not meant to be said at the end of a sermon or at the end of a prayer, then you recite the Lord's Prayer. No. The Lord's Prayer is like a building. It is like a structure that Jesus prepared for us. And he said, from now, you are going to be building on this foundation.
Amen.
And the Lord's Prayer was a foundation of how a believer was going to live his life. He was going to seek the will of God, that which is in heaven, to come down to where we are. Between God and Adam, who used to go and visit the earth? It is God who used to come to visit. It is not us going to heaven. It is the will of God, that which is in heaven, to come to where we are. Praise God. God made a visible kingdom called the earth to look like the heaven. You know, heaven is not a physical place. Heaven is not a seeable. It's not something you can see. It's a spiritual location. But the earth is the representation of that which is in the spirit. Praise God. I told you that we existed before we became. So what you see, what yourself, you existed in God according to Ephesians chapter 4 verse 1. You existed in God before the foundations of the earth. Continue, please.
Forgive us our debt as we also have forgiven our debtors.
Forgive us of our debt. Jesus said, you have to repent and you have to learn to keep asking. Why? Because he said somewhere in the book of John chapter 17, that I am not asking that you may take them away, but that you may keep them from the evil one. Why? Because where they are is where the enemy has his throne. That means man will always run into some mistakes. And I am not condoning you running into any mistakes. I am only saying that error is to human. And at some point as a believer, you will find yourself on the wrong side. What do you need to do? Ask God, forgive us our trespasses, and help us also that we may forgive those who trespass against us. That means, as a believer, you must never